Hey everyone, we've covered all kinds of methods to create Java class instances. What if we wanted to create an instance that, just like the one over there? We just want to copy. And that's what we're covering. The copy constructor in Java, coming up next. So here's a situation. We need a copy of an object. We have an A, and after copying our object, we have a second object that's the same in every way as A, but it's not A. One example of why we'd want to do this, say we have an enemy in a video game. It has a number of hit points, a weapon it's carrying, a tool belt full of tools, and a name. This baddie has the ability to duplicate itself, so when it duplicates, we need to create a copy of the enemy so that there's two, each with their own hit points, own weapon, own tools, etc. The first thought might be to create a new instance like this. We have an enemy 1, and we create an enemy 2, and assign it to the first enemy. Done. That really didn't work. We just have two enemy variables pointing to the same enemy. This didn't copy anything, and we still have one instance. We need to create a copy constructor in Java to have a new enemy instance. A copy constructor is this. It's a method that takes an instance of a class and returns a new instance copied exactly like the first class. You can use a static factory method, but best practice is use a constructor that takes a single instance of the class as a parameter. We'll create our copy constructor to use a constructor. So what goes in our copy constructor? Well, the next thought is to create a new enemy object and copy the attributes over. That looks like this. Unfortunately, this won't work either. We wanted two distinct enemies, but we really got two enemies sharing a weapon and a tool belt. If we change a value on one weapon, say to overheating, both enemies will experience the change. That's because we did something called a shallow copy. It's interesting to note, the hit points and the name were not a problem to copy. If we change the hit points on one enemy, the other is not affected. The reason is primitive values are just values. There's no pointer or reference to the value. It's immutable. So what about the name? Strings are classes, so do we have the same problem with strings? If we change the name from George to Gracie, will they both be called Gracie? No. Strings are immutable classes. We can't change the value, so what would happen is we'd assign the name reference to a new string object. After copying and changing the name, the enemy's names would point to different string instances. To have truly different enemies, we need to do something called a deep copy. This means every class attribute must be copied, and deep really means deep. Remember our tool belt? We can't just copy arrays of class instances. Every element needs a copy too. Otherwise, the belts will just point to the same instances.
It gets ugly real quick for classes with large attribute trees. However, to have a true copy, that's what we need to do in our copy constructor. Make instances of everything. Best practice is copy constructors provide deep copies.
Now, some of you are probably thinking there's gotta be a better way. Digging through the Java API, we'd notice, hey, every object has a clone method. The clone method is a copy constructor implemented as a static factory. Kinda. Unfortunately, the clone method is a colossally horrible idea. The way clone works is our object must implement clonable in order to be cloned. The reason is the object class has a clone method that checks to see if the class implements clonable. If it doesn't, clone must throw an exception. So every time we clone, we need to check for exceptions. When we clone an object, we really need to call super on the clone method. The reason is we don't always have access to all of the state inside the object. Some state might be private. So we need each class in the class hierarchy to handle its own part for clone. And if any part of our class hierarchy doesn't implement clonable, the whole thing falls apart.
All right, so long story short, too late. There's nothing in Java that provides deep copies for free. So what do? Well, if we need a copy constructor, step one is to write our own. This is better because we don't need to mess around with the clonable interface and it doesn't throw exceptions. It's just a lot of work. The advantage of a copy constructor is you have a complete control over how it's implemented and it returns the class instance you want. The second thing that'll help you when making copy constructors is in immutable objects. Remember earlier, we had no problems with primitives and strings. If our enemies consisted of immutable objects, copies become very easy. It really depends on what we're doing, but if we can avoid mutable objects, it will make things much easier. And finally, another option is don't copy anything. Make sure copying is really what you need to do. There's nothing inherently wrong with copying objects, but we do need to be very careful. If we can avoid it, even better. So, thanks for watching. Copying instances can get very tricky, so if you have any questions, let me know in the comments. Make sure you subscribe to the channel so you don't miss a video, and liking the video helps me understand what I'm doing right. So, if you like the video, you know what to do. And with that, thanks for watching.